Welcome to the world of Ebenezer Scrooge. Please follow him wherever he goes.
And enjoy your time in the past, present, and future.
In my own quarters.
Oh, the rest! What are you at work? My own hire!
Well, don't you have the common sense not to barge in on a man, a gentleman?
It ain't no fault of mine if you're rolling about long after the cock done crowed.
Yeah, he done crowed a long time ago.
You detestable crone! I'll not stand for it. Be gone, both of you!
Deny me a morning's wages! Not bloody likely!
Don't you swear it to me, you hag! Leave my sight at once!
You can't just throw us out! We can't get no more work today!
Watch me! And it'll be a cleaner sweep than the likes of you have ever made!
Merry Christmas.
Humbug.
Christmas a humbug, Uncle. You don't mean that, to be sure.
I do. What reason have you to be merry? You're poor enough.
What reason have you to be dismal? You're rich enough.
Bah, humbug.
Don't be cross, Uncle.
Well, what else can I be when I live in a world of fools? Merry Christmas. What's Christmas to you but a time for finding yourself another year older and not another hour richer? I could work my will, every idiot with Merry Christmas on his lips would be boiled in his own pudding with a steak of holly to his heart.
Uncle.
Nephew, you keep Christmas in your way and let me keep it in mine.
But you don't keep it.
Well, then let me leave it alone then. Much good it has ever done you.
There are many things from which I may have made more profit from, I dare say. But I'm sure that I've always thought of Christmas time, apart from the Reverend Stuart's sacred origin, as a good time. A kind, forgiving, and charitable time. a time when men and women open their shut-up hearts and think of one another as if we really were on the same path from birth to grave. And though it has never put a scrap of gold in my pocket, I believe it has done me good, and I say God bless it.
You're a powerful speaker, sir. I wonder you don't go into Parliament.
Don't be churlish, Uncle. Say you'll come and dine with us tomorrow.
You'll see me dead first.
But why?
Why? Why did you get married?
Because I fell in love.
Because you fell in love. World of fools!
I want nothing from you. I ask nothing of you. Why can't we be friends?
I said I've no time.
I'm sorry, with all my heart. But I'll keep my Christmas humor to the last. So Merry Christmas, Uncle. God save you.
Ah.
And a Happy New Year.
Humbug.
Ah, Bob Cratchit. A very Merry Christmas and Happy Returns of the Season to you.
The same to you, sir. The very same. Merry Christmas.
Enough! Enough! You'll lose your station if you don't put a stopper in that nonsense right now, Bob Cratchit. 15 shilling a week and a family to feed. What's so merry about that, huh?
Well, begging your pardon, sir, but I thought it rude not to wish your nephew return to the season.
Ah, we're all fools. May, what have you been going on with your Merry Christmas? A whole swarm of customers are already waiting to pay on their debts. Waiting to the last minute, of course. All right, then, see if you can form some decent lines and give your name to my clerk there, if you please. All right, look sharp if you can and have your payments ready.
Do I have the pleasure of addressing Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?
Mr. Marley died 7 years ago. Oh. This very night.
Oh. Well, I have no doubt that his generosity is well represented in his surviving partner.
No doubt there.
Well, then, in this joyous season of the year, it is the noble responsibility of those more fortunate to contribute to the needs of the local poor, for they suffer greatly at this time. So, Mr. Scrooge, what can I put you down for?
Nothing.
You wish to remain anonymous?
Are there no prisons?
Well, there's plenty of prisons.
Are there no workhouses?
There's plenty of workhouses, I'm sorry to say.
Well, good. Let the poor go there.
So I'd rather die than go there.
Well, then they'd better do it than decrease the surplus population. Good day, sir.
Well, this is quite unusual. Upon my honor.
You want all day tomorrow, I suppose.
It's quite convenient, sir.
Well, it's not convenient and it's not fair. You wouldn't think it fair if I docked you a day's wages, eh?
'Tis only once a year, sir.
A poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th day of December. Bah, humbug! Be here all the earlier the next day, mind you.
Oh, thank you kindly, sir. I will.
Yes, yes, yes. Is that all? All accounted for? Good, good. Then be off with you all, now then. And you too, Bob Cratchit. I can tell I won't get an honest day's work out of you.
Well, thank you, Mr. Scrooge, and Merry... Well, good day, sir.
For the merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. For Jesus Christ, our Savior, was born on Christmas Day.
You save us all from side and far away.
Stop that infernal squawking this instant, young man.
Apologies, Governor. Song to keep me warm on a cold Christmas Eve, and some fair penny for the tune.
Well, you've not met such a fool like that in me. Now keep your tunes to yourself and let sensible folk alone. Be off with you now. Speak up, I say. Show yourself. Who's there? Humbug.
on the anniversary of... Never mind. Mustard or a crumb of cheese. There's more of gravy than grave about you. Bah, humbug! Oh, mercy, aberration! Why do you trouble me?
I wander the earth forever seeing, but never touching. Unable to do all that I might have done to reverse this fate.
You are shackled. Tell me why.
These are the chains I forged in life, crafted by my selfish and cruel deeds. They bear witness to your own. Though not visible to you, they are a heavy and ponderous load.
No, Jacob, speak comfort to me.
I have none to give. Like you, I squandered all opportunities to ease the burdens of others. And now I must roam this earth forever in the chains of bondage I have wrought for myself.
But you were always such a good man of business.
Business? Business! Mankind should have been my business. Mercy. Charity, benevolence. Oh, I was blind. Blind! And now I am found! Found! Oh! I have watched you these 7 years, Ebenezer. Watched you squander all the riches that might have been yours. Riches beyond money, riches beyond your damnable pride and spite at life.
How come you now?
I know not why I am visible to you, but heed this. For in this holy season and by this grace, you have a chance to reverse your fate.
Yes, Jacob, you are always such a good friend to me. Speak.
You will be haunted by 3 spirits.
I think I'd rather not.
You must. This may be your only chance. Oh, I do wish someone had come to me with this warning.
Yes, Jacob, yes, I'm listening.
Expect the first when the dawn bell tolls tomorrow. Now look to me no more, Ebenezer, but remember this warning.
Jacob, Jacob, please, tell me more, Jacob. Dream, nothing more, more. Humbug!
Wow!
Wake, Ebenezer Scrooge, and know me.
Are you the spirit whose coming was foretold to me?
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
A long past?
Your past.
Well, what business have you with me?
Rise and walk with me, and I will show you.
But I am just a mortal man.
In my company, you will be safe among the shadows of memory we will see. Forget.
Does he?
These shadows have no consciousness of our presence here.
Christmas Eve, left alone. So many years I spent at school, in season and out. But Father always said, yeah, never mind.
Books were my company. Its characters were my playfellows. Oh, Ali Baba and the genie. Oh, Valentine and his wild brother Orson. Oh, I knew them so well. They were...
A lonely existence for one so young, who did not know the games of other boys, nor the love of a family around him. Why, is that a tear on your cheek?
Oh, no, certainly not. I was just thinking of a young lad this evening who was singing carols in the street, and I... Never mind.
Brother, dear brother, I've come to bring you home at last.
Oh, Fan, dear sister, can it be?
My dear sister Fan, there she is.
You come to bring me home?
Yes, home for good and always. Father is so much kinder now. And he spoke so gently to me last night, I wasn't afraid to ask if you might come home. And you're never to return here again, Ebenezer, but to be a man and set up as an apprentice. You need never be alone again.
Oh, you're quite the little woman, Fan. Lead on!
Always a delicate creature whom a strong wind might blow away. But she had a large heart.
So she had.
She died a woman. And left a child.
Yes, my nephew, Fred. So much like his mother.
Let's see another Christmas, shall we?
Why, it's Fezziwig alive again! Oh, my life, there he is! No better master was ever had, no sir, no better!
Hilly-ho, my husband! Stand in with me, won't ye? For I've a powerful urge to dance!
With a will, wife, with a will!
Mrs. Fezziwig, what a delightful woman! Such a jolly couple, so generous of spirit!
Yo-ho, lads, no more work tonight. It's Christmas Eve. The guests will soon arrive.
Welcome, my fellow apprentice. Oh, no, Ben, always a good friend of me he was.
Ebenezer, hang these garlands, won't ye? Dick Wren fetch some victuals while my bonny bride and I practice a few steps.
Such a merry time. Such a grand time.
Such a simple thing. Meaningless to fill folks so full of gratitude.
Simple? Meaningless? Why, for only a few pence he had the power to lighten our service, to bring us joy and happiness.
So much worth more so than a fortune.
What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. I should like to speak to my clerk just now.
Ah, Belle. Will you help Ebenezer with the trimming? He suddenly has no eye for it.
Belle.
Might I have a dance tonight?
Yes, Ebenezer.
And may I see you home? There's a beautiful moon this evening.
I'd like that very much.
I should like to speak to my nephew and his wife just now. She's, caring young lass, and I...
They are very young, but love each other very much.
Yes, Spirit. It shows in every word and every gesture. I remember I asked him why he got married, and I...
To be with them is to remember when you were once in love.
Yes, I was. But then...
There is one more Christmas you must observe.
Oh, no, Spirit, I cannot bear
it.
You protest, Ebenezer, but this should have been said a long time before now.
I don't know what you speak of.
It should be a little matter to you at any rate.
You speak of being replaced, but by whom? All I do is work. I see no one but the other clerks in the counting house.
Yes, you are correct. All you do is work.
Speak plainly, please. Who has replaced you?
An idol.
What idol?
A golden one.
Oh. Oh, I see. This is the way of the world, Belle. There is nothing in this life so cruel as poverty, and yet nothing so disgraced as the pursuit of wealth. An unfair judgment. I thought better of you.
But true, all the same.
But I do it for you. For us.
Never asked you to.
I am being responsible.
You are being consumed, Ebenezer. I have seen your nobler passions fall off one by one until all that remains is your desire for gain. All that drives you is greed.
I may have grown wiser in business, but I have not changed toward you. Have I?
Our contract is an old one, made when we were both poor and content to be so, and felt with one heart the simple things that would bring us both joy. But we were changed, and now... come to release you from your promise.
Have I ever sought release?
In word? No. But tell me, if we were to meet now, would you still seek me for a bride?
I can see you think not.
And would I be wrong? A penniless girl with no dowry and no aspirations for great wealth besides.
You fool! You fool!
I would gladly think otherwise. But you both know... would be a lie.
Stop her! Tell her!
Yes. It would be.
So, I release you. With a full heart for the love of him you once were. Goodbye, Ebenezer Scrooge. May you be happy in the life you have chosen.
Oh, Spirit, why do you delight in tormenting me? Remove me, show me no more.
I told you these shadows were things that have been. That they are painful is no fault of mine. They can't be undone. But take heed.
Oh, I can't bear it any longer.
Into another's company you must go, for my time is past.
Come and know me better, man. You have not seen the likes of me before.
Never.
I am the ghost of Christmas presents. Look upon me. My brothers number more than 1,800. Yet you have never walked forth with one of us. No, not until tonight.
Oh, Spirit. I have seen such things this night that have begun a work in me.
Oh, please, please show me that which might benefit me all the more. I believe I am ready to hear it.
And look fast, Ebenezer.
Were that not a beautiful service this morning? And you behaved good as gold. But you look too thoughtful for such a joyous day, my lad.
I was hoping the people in church might see me, because I am a cripple. And that might make them think of he who made the lame beggars walk and the blind men see. It's for him we make merry on this day and count our blessings every day. Is it not, Father?
It is, Tim. It is.
What ho, happily met!
Martha, my dear girl!
Merry Christmas to you, Father, and you, Tim. Mother will wonder that half her family's been spirited off this morning.
Now see here, Tim, your sister will be as late as we. But your mother can't take the scuttle brush to us all at once.
We'll send Tim in first, won't we? I can nearly smell a goose, can't you? Let's hurry!
Let's go.
I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day, on Christmas Day.
I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day in the morning.
Mother, Peter, Belinda, Nancy, we're home.
And we have a surprise for you, someone you may have been missing.
Why, Martha, home at last. The children and I gave up looking for you.
It was getting so late.
We thought you'd never come home.
Finally. It wouldn't seem like Christmas Day without having everyone here.
Look at all this. You've been busy. Look, I'll show you how to do it.
I sewed this ornament for you.
I helped too. Truly, I did.
Girls, let's clean that up now. And Peter, will you help me set the table?
This will be perfect to decorate the table.
There, now sit. Sit, everyone. Robert, you'll bring the goose, won't you?
Merry Christmas, my dearest ones, and no dear ones that ever were. I'm a very fortunate man, but let us not forget the founder of this feast, Mr. Scrooge. God bless him.
The founder of the feast, indeed. I wish he were here. I'd give him a piece of my mind, and wouldn't he have a bit of indigestion then?
My dear, the children, Christmas Day.
It could only be Christmas Day, which we would drink the health of such a mean and unfeeling man as Mr. Scrooge. You know he is, Robert. No one knows it better.
May he deserve our pity, then, if not our affection.
I'll drink his health for your sake, and the day's, but not his own. But he won't see pity from me, though it might heap coals upon his head to be thought so low by such as I.
Oh, he'd think a heap of coals much too expensive. God bless Mr. Scrooge.
God bless Mr. Scrooge.
God bless Mr. Scrooge.
And God bless us, everyone.
Go away, Ebenezer!
Come! Come see another gathering we also remembered.
What's that uncle of yours? Why don't you tell him Merry Christmas this year?
I did.
And what did he say?
As I live, he said Christmas is a humbug.
No, never he did.
He did. And he believed it, too.
More shame to him.
He's a hard old fellow, and in truth, not as I'd wish him to be.
Oh, but he's very rich, Fred, from what I've heard.
That he is, but little good it does him. He doesn't use it for his own benefit, much less to help those in need.
I really couldn't have patience with him.
Why, Fred went over there yesterday to ask him to come here today, although he knew the answer.
I couldn't be mad at him if I tried. I'm sorry for him. Who does he hurt by his ill humor? Only himself. What does he gain? Nothing. What does he lose?
A good dinner.
A very good dinner.
Yes, a very good dinner. But he also loses... Well, he loses this. He loses comrades in arms who char with us through life, be it pleasant sailing or stormy seas, and who find with us a communal shore, wherein we might count ourselves richly blessed for having arrived here, together.
All the gold in the world's not worth more than that shore, my love. You are absolutely right.
Here, here. I'll raise a glass for that. To friends.
To friends!
And to Uncle Scrooge, whose expense has given us plenty of merriment, and we would be ungrateful not to drink his health at least.
Yes, to Uncle Scrooge.
Uncle Scrooge! Merry Christmas to you, Uncle. Wherever you are tonight.
Now it's time we set this party to caroling. Come all!
Here we come, a-wassailing among the leaves so green. Here we come, a-wandering so fair to be seen. Love and joy unto you.
He wishes me merry and drinks to my health even after I treated him so poorly. So much like his mother, always ready to love, always ready to forgive. Tiny Tim, he looks so frail. Will he live?
I see a vacant seat and a clutch without an owner.
Oh, surely not, Spirits. Say he will live.
If these shadows remain unchanged, the boy will die. None of my brothers yet to come will see him. No, not even the next.
Oh, no, spirit.
What then? If he be likely to die,
let him do so and decrease the surplus population.
No, you shame me with my own words.
Aye, who are you to decide who is worthy under heaven to live or to die? Can all your gold buy you redemption?
No, spirit, no.
Ah, my time is coming to an end.
Whose are these spirits? Be they yours?
No. This boy's ignorance. This girl.
Penny for the poor. Has anybody got a penny?
You're so high and mighty.
They cling to me at present, but they appeal to you for their future. Beware them both.
Have they no refuge? Have they no resources?
Are there no prisons? Are there no workhouses?
No, no, spirit, no! I know who you are, Spectre, and I fear you most of all.
Did you hear? Old Scratch goes home at last.
Good riddance to bad rubbish, if you ask me. I thought he'd never die.
And what's he done with all his money?
Do you know? Won't be given to charity, actually.
Not my friend.
Are you going to the funeral?
Only if lunch is provided.
A whole one, if any, I imagine.
Hardly worth it.
Good day.
Well, met then, Arthur Anchoring to see myself.
Who's at loss for a few things like these? Not a dead man, I suppose.
Well, look here. Blankets, bed curtains, and this shirt, look, it ain't got one ola rent in it. Why, they'd have wasted it if it hadn't been for me.
What do you call wasting it?
Putting it on until we buried him. Somebody was fool enough to do it, but I took it off again.
You would never want to blush, Mrs. Dilber.
Spirit, who is that man? Oh, no. I believed he could change. Truly, Mother always did.
Mother loved him and knew how hard his young life had been, how the cruelty of his father and how the fear of poverty shaped him. She knew his tenderness, too.
Poor Uncle Scrooge, I'll bother you no more.
Oh, no.
Spirit, please hear me. I'm not the man I once was. Please say these events might yet be changed.
Look well, Ebenezer.
No, no!
What's she, Ali Baba? The king you have come to me.
Have you forgotten them?
I'm coming, also.
Here we are, home at last and for Christmas Day.
I'll always be a little fan.
Let's play hide and seek. I'll hide first.
It's not the size of the dance floor, my boy.
It's who you're on it with. Walk me home, Ebenezer. There's a beautiful moon tonight.
My son!
Oh,
my dear son!
No, no! No! I will change, spirit! I will change! Jacob, thank you, and spirits, thank you. Bell, Fan, oh dear, dear ones, I'm sorry, so sorry, but please know that I will always honor Christmas in my heart now, and I will live for the past, the present, and the future, and I will never forget the lessons they have taught me.
On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me two turtle doves and a partridge.
You there, boy! What day is it?
Today? Why, it's Christmas Day!
No, oh, Christmas Day! I haven't missed it after all. Oh, glorious day! Oh, lad, run as fast as you can down to the poulterer's shop and have that prize turkey charged to the account of Ebenezer Scrooge, and have it delivered to the home of Bob Cratchit post haste. Oh, and boy, that's for the song.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, and nothing you dismay. For he's this
time. You best a fine sir, Merry Christmas!
Mr. Scrooge?
Yes, my name, and you might want to write it down in that ledger of yours, next to a certain sum.
Absolutely. Positively.
That's just the beginning, and please allow me to apologize and allow me many, many back payments.
Oh, yes, indeed. Indeed, I... Yeah. Merry Christmas.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let every see...
Bob Cratchit, just the man I was looking for.
Oh, well, hello, Mr. Scrooge, and returns of the season to you, if I may.
Yes, you may, good sir. Fine, sir. Now, Bob, when you arrive home, please find a little bit of the amount that you are owed waiting for you. And tomorrow, we shall discuss your new salary and your new position as partner in the business. Oh, and a new coal scuttle, too.
What's all this, then? Robert, what's he saying?
He's wishing us a Merry Christmas. Mr. Scrooge, wishing us a very Merry Christmas.
God bless us, everyone.
Amen, lad, amen. Now off with you all now. Oh. Uncle!
Uncle Scrooge!
Oh, Fred, Catherine, hello. Oh, I know this is quite unexpected, but leave it. I wondered if we could get to know each other a little better and maybe become friends.
Uncle Scrooge, you are so welcome, of course. I had hoped.
Oh, but... thank you, boy. Thank you. And, oh, my dearest Catherine, are you crying?
Oh, Uncle Scrooge, I'm so happy. So very happy.
Oh, there. Now, I know I've made an awful mess of things before now, and I'm heartily sorry for it, but... I know that...
Why, come now. No regrets upon Christmas Day.
Much good they do me. Much good they do me. And much good you do me. Why, seeing you there remembers my sister and of what great memories and more memories to come because it's Christmas Day and God bless it. And hearken, mankind, and hear ye, London. Merry Christmas. God bless us, everyone.